I'm Keith Huber, Lieutenant General, U.S. Army, retired, and we're going to talk about an academic concept of leadership, and especially leadership in teams. And there's a gentleman by the name of Lencioni, which talks about leaders need to overcome 5 dysfunctions of teams. It's an interesting way to begin the conversation. It almost makes you feel that you need to raise your hand and say, okay, my organization is dysfunctional. The first dysfunction that you need to overcome is the absence of trust. If you ask yourself, how does someone earn your trust? It will divulge, you will say, here's the requirements, here's my expectations that must be met for me to trust you. Or if you want to reflect upon when someone you know says something and on the outside you go, gee, that makes a lot of sense. It's logical we should do that. But in the back of your mind, you've got this nagging voice going, yeah, but there must be more to it. There must be something I don't understand. And you ask yourself why. It's because you don't trust that person. That person has not demonstrated to you the human quality of characteristics that you demand for someone to earn your trust, for you to give someone your trust. You expect that person to care more about you than themselves. If everything they do is for their own self-promotion, you expect them to be honest. You expect them to be candid. You don't trust someone solely based upon you think they know the right answer to all the questions, but you trust them that they will try their very best to make the right decision that's for the benefit of the team and for your benefit rather than their own self-promotion. The second dysfunction that we want to talk about is the fear of conflict. Conflict is that friction that allows us to change, that allows us to see different perspectives, that allows us to correct mistakes. You shouldn't fear conflict, but it gets back into how do you trust someone? How do you trust someone that then when they tell you you're going to do something? I mean, my 38 years on active duty in the Army as an infantryman, as a Green Beret, when I looked you in the eye and I shook your hand and I said I was going to do something, it got done. The only excuse for it not getting done would have to be that I was dead. So how do you develop this bond of trust? How do you disagree with what people want to do? How do you disagree with the way they want to do it without it being made into a conflict? Conflict brings other ideas. And so when people trust you, not to ridicule them, not to go, gee, that's a stupid idea, not to publicly humiliate them, but to respectfully listen to their different perspective, you'll know that you'll get a better solution if other people add their perspectives and their opinions. And they'll only do that if they don't view it as a conflict. Avoidance of accountability. It's amazing to me how many leaders are out there who think they can avoid accountability. If you're the leader, if you're assigned, if you're appointed, if you're elected, if you're selected, if you're the leader, then you need to take charge of all personnel and equipment in sight. And your organization will look to you in times of stress to determine the quality of your leadership, to determine whether they can trust you, because you will step up and go, this is my responsibility, I'm accountable. And so don't avoid accountability. And oh, by the way, the members of your organization will hold you accountable. And what you want within your organization is for everyone to assume part of that responsibility, because the goal is not an individual success, the goal is the team success. A lack of commitment. If you aren't present for whatever excuse you got, if you aren't present physically at an event, at an operation, at the critical point of when the friction and the stress is the highest, when your people need to see you the most, you have demonstrated that you don't care. And if you don't care, people aren't going to trust you. They need to know that you're committed to them, to their safety, to their success. Inattention to results. Data, return on investment, measures of effectiveness. How do you as the leader define success in your organization? And the results that you need to pay attention to, the results that you need to discuss, are the overall results of the team, not whether or not you look good as the leader, but whether the team has accomplished its task. Thank you.